It is 5:59. We're 1 minute away from starting. Before we start, can I point out a couple of essentials? Can I point out that the emergency exits are there, 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 and there? Can I point out that the male toilets are through that door across the hall, and the female toilets are through that door across the hall? And could I ask you all, please, to take these things and make sure they are on silent. You won't want to turn them off because you'll probably be taking photographs. Okay, please make sure they're on silent. Okay. Could you please stand while the faculty process in? Mr. Music? These are the people who have brought your children on this journey and worked with you to get your children to this point. They're important people, but they're not the most important people tonight. Please stay standing while the most important people tonight process in. Thank you. Please be seated. Before we begin tonight, I'd like to invite Mrs. Bindu Oberoi and our guest of honour, Mr. Craig Johnson, to please come up and light the deer. Just wait for a moment for the latecomers to find their seats. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise one more time while Simran leads us in the national anthem? Thank you. And now we can officially get started. And it is my pleasure to welcome you all to the Oberoi International School's 6th annual graduation ceremony. You've waited a long time to hear that, haven't you? Let's be clear about the purpose of tonight's event. This event is not a publicity exercise for the Oberoi International School. It's not designed to show the world how fantastic we are. Tonight is a family event. It's an important family event. You see these young people here? They come into this auditorium as kids, as school kids. And they leave as adults. That's how important the event is. It's a family event, and it's for families. Tonight is for mums and dads, You have spent a lot of years investing heavily, both financially and emotionally, in these young people. And tonight is your opportunity to watch them graduate and feel pride. And if you want to shed a tear or two, that's okay. And if when your child comes up to receive the diploma, if you want to get out of your seat and come down to the front and take a photo, you go right ahead. Or if you want to sit in your seat and rather than collect a photograph, collect an enduring memory, that's okay too. We have an official photographer. He'll do a good job. It's up to you. So welcome. Welcome, mums and dads. And now,
I need to get a little closer because I need to talk to these guys and say a very warm welcome to the class of 2016. Whose phone is that? You guys look great. You really do. Your little faces are all shining with anticipation because you think it's all going to be so wonderful, don't you? And you're absolutely right. It's not going to be easy, but it's going to be wonderful. You know, every year, I think the same thing. I look at the graduating class, and I think to myself, the heels cannot possibly get any higher. And every year, I'm wrong. And ladies, I'm sure there are those who've told you that you look ridiculous, that it's dangerous. Let me add to this by saying you look fabulous. Be careful on the stairs, but don't worry too much about it, because we will have able-bodied young men from the 11th grade to help you up and down the stairs. And let me tell you that the task of helping pretty girls in high heels up and down stairs is one for which we had no shortage of volunteers. Now, all over the world, there are heads of school who've been told to get up and give the welcome, and they get up and they give the welcome, and then they make a speech. Because they can. And I'm no different. I'm sorry. It won't be long. Because I've been around a long time. I could tell you so much stuff. I could give you so much advice, tell you so many things that I think you need to know, that you just fall asleep. So I'm going to give you two words. That's all. I ask you to remember them. If we meet again at a reunion or an event like that, I will ask you what those two words are. And if you cannot tell me, there will be detentions. My first word is humility. Humility is something that we don't talk an awful lot about. And yet, I think it's important. I have spent a lot of time mentoring and advising young international school teacher candidates, and they say to me, when I'm in an interview, what sort of thing should I say? And I tell them, tell him what you're interested in, tell him what you're passionate about, and tell him what you've done. Don't tell him how well you've done it. Because if he wants to know, he'll find out. He'll pick up your references. I think if you have to tell somebody how fantastic you are, he's not going to listen. Now, I'm going to ask you a question, and I'm asking this question purely for the reason of trying to point out the power of humility. I don't want you to answer the question. I'm not going to answer the question. It's a political question. I probably shouldn't ask it. But if you don't answer it, it'll be okay. Think ahead 100 years, and you're looking at a bunch of 12th grade students reading their history books. And those history books are talking about the greatest leader that the world has seen. Who is more likely to be the greatest leader the world has ever seen? Mahatma Gandhi or Donald Trump? Humility is a powerful and important thing. My second word is integrity. And integrity is one of those things that we all know what it is, and yet we struggle with how to define it. I mean, some people think integrity is the same as being 100% honest all of the time. I'm not so sure. Guys, let me talk to the guys for a minute. Here's something that's really likely to happen to you in your life. You're going to get married, and there will come a time when your wife will turn to you and she will say these words: "Do I look fat in this dress?" Fellas, there's only one answer. I don't care if she looks like the Hindenburg blimp. There is only one acceptable answer. No, I don't think integrity is the same as absolute honesty. I think the best definition I've ever heard of integrity is this: integrity is a measure of how you behave when nobody is looking. How you behave when you're absolutely sure that whatever you do, nobody is going to find out. Integrity is one of those things that if you have it, then trust me, sooner or later, people will realize this and they will treat you differently. Integrity and humility. They cost you nothing. Nobody can ever take them away from you unless you let them. So now, that's all from me. I wish you many, many things. I wish you continued good health. I wish you happiness and abundance. I wish you all the success you deserve, no more, no less. And I hope you find love in your lives. Thank you very much. Now, we're going to hear from two young ladies who have been elected by their peers to speak for their peers. Would you please welcome Vasundhara and Danny to the stage?
She entered school wearing her Converse with different colored laces and